Welcome to the California Department of Education, Integrated and Designated English Language Development Transitional Kindergarten through Grade 12 video series. This video is used by permission of the owner, Sobrato Early Academic Language Program, a California nonprofit corporation. Copyright 2019, Sobrato Early Academic Language Program. All rights reserved.
We'll tell you a story of how this cotton becomes the jeans that we are wearing.
We're in a second grade classroom, and they're doing a unit on supply and demand and goods and services.
So we'll use the language of sequence.
Today's lesson was really zooming in on some content that they'd covered through a drawn label about how cotton becomes jeans and the different steps it goes through to become jeans.
So we're going to be even practicing using what kind of language?
Sequence.
Sequencing language, that's right.
This lesson is focused on the language function of sequence to tell how something goes from the initial natural resource into the product.
So we're going to start out telling the story of cotton to jeans in the present, and then we'll move it into the past.
Today she began by pulling a group for designated ELD. She has all three levels of English language learners in her class, emerging, expanding, and bridging students, and she began by pulling all of her English language learners to the carpet.
So we're going to take that story of cotton plant to jeans, and we're going to tell it using all that rich sequencing language, but we're going to need a really important part of speech to help us do that. What part of speech are we going to need to tell about all the action that happens? We're going to need our... No, you said it. You said it. We're going to need our verbs to tell that story. And I was wondering if I could have you read with me some of the verbs that we are going to use to tell the story that we think we'll need.
Grow.
Oh, I hear Ariana.
Grow.
Load.
Transform.
Weave.
Make.
Cut.
Beautiful.
Assemble.
Manufacture.
During designated ELD, we're doing two things. We're thinking about how to prepare for the lesson, and so here you saw her front-loading some of the language and really giving students a chance to orally practice what they were later going to be doing independently or with the whole group. So she was preparing them for that.
Following this, who did what?
The factory.
The factory workers. What did they do? What did they do in the past? Did they make it? They
made.
Made.
I just heard it.
They
made
the
denim.
They made the
denim
fabric. Beautiful.
The other part of designated ELD is in response to. So you saw some of the work she'd been doing is really listening to her students and then identifying, oh, this group of kiddos is really struggling with verbs in the past tense. And so she's done some really intentional work around verbs and really responding to what she saw and heard.
The next step in the process is manufacturing.
With that group of students, she then had a chance to review a chant that they had learned whole class, but this time really zooming in on that language of sequence.
From there she loads it and transports it.
And it was a chant that not only embedded the content that she's working on in this unit of supply and demand and goods and services, but also embedded the language of sequencing.
We're going to hunt in our chant for some excellent sequencing language. And I want you to touch your brain. And with your other hand, I want you to put a finger up for every bit of sequencing language that you see.
And so students highlighted and had a chance to do a think, pair, share and talk with their partner about what were the sequential words or phrases in that chant.
Initially, from there, the next step in the process.
Giving students an opportunity to share their idea with another person before being asked to share in a group really allows for everyone to have a chance to speak. It's an oral rehearsal.
I think finally, the consumers. Buy the jeans and purchase the jeans.
When we pull small groups for designated ELD, we have an opportunity to provide a safe environment. Students feel more comfortable taking risks. They're in a small, safe group of other English language learners.
Beautiful. So, if we're going to talk about the process of cotton plants to jeans, I'll take a quiet hint. Where are we going to start? Ariana.
Initially, the farmer grows the cotton with natural resources like water, sun, and soil.
Then with that group, she used the drawn label that they had previously learned whole class and then revisited whole class. This time what they were doing is pulling the information off the drawn label onto a graphic organizer.
Oh, what was some of that language we could use to tell about what happens next? What happens in the middle? Oh, the next step in the process, following this. Actually, let's see, Justin.
The next step in the process.
Great, go for it. The next step in the process.
The next step is when the denim factory takes the cotton and wovens it into fabric.
Wonderful.
She went over the different types of sentence frames, really providing students with opportunities about where they choose to enter into the language.
Following this, the farmer transports it to the cotton into the factory.
She's got these three different levels of English language learners in her classroom, and in looking at the ELD standards for second grade, those different levels require different levels of scaffolding.
You are going to take our sequencing graphic organizer. You are going to sketch the process of cotton plant to jeans, and you are going to tell the story to your partner. You're going to practice telling the story.
She excused the bridging students to go off and work with a partner using a graphic organizer to recreate the steps from cotton to jeans and then orally practice that with a partner.
Initially, the farmer grows the cotton. And then he transports the cotton to the manufacturers.
The manufacturer workers make denim fabric, cut and sew and assemble them.
They sell them in stores or online. And then the consumers, at the end, the consumers buy the jeans.
She kept with her emerging and expanding students that still needed a little more of the scaffold in the form of teacher support.
I want us now to practice telling the story of this exact pair of jeans. Christian, it didn't get made today. It got made some time ago. So we're going to need to use verbs that tell about things that happened in the past.
When she was with just the emerging and expanding students, she began to really dive into that idea of past tense verbs and really supporting and scaffolding those students to use past tense verbs to talk about how those jeans came into being.
So while the farmers grow the cotton, what if it happened the other day or last year?
They grew.
The farmers
grew
the cotton. Will you say that with me? The farmers grew the cotton.
They had the sentence frames there right next to them to refer to. They had the realia of the drawn label and the real images. And then they also had the support of their friends as they did those think pair shares to tell this story in the past tense of how these genes came into being.
Supply and demand rule the marketplace.
In integrated ELD, she began with two chants, giving students a chance to get their wiggles out, to have blood moving through their body. And these were both chants that embedded that high level of academic vocabulary as well as the content of the unit.
A step in the process is manufacturing.
One of them was also focused on the sequencing language, was the same chant that she had a chance to practice earlier with the designated ELD group.
The distributors transport the jeans to the merchants.
The students who had been in designated ELD with her had already had a chance to practice and internalize this language, had already had the chance to use sequencing language to tell this story.
All right, so I'm going to look for a team that's ready to share out their sentence, and I would love to hear from reporter number one.
The game she was playing involved each of the students in the group had a different number, and she was then calling on a random number, allowing for that kind of idea of equity for different students to share.
Pedro.
Initially, the farmer grows the cotton with natural resources like sunlight, water, and soil.
Diana.
The menu. Following this, the manufacturers make denim fabric and cut, sew, and assemble.
In SEAL, we have a huge focus on collaboration and the importance of students having an opportunity to build the skills of collaboration, which are these 21st century skills.
And do you know what I saw? Is I really noticed Team Farmer was really doing an excellent job of all doing their part.
So at the end of this activity, she directed students to head back to their desks and now to independently create their own graphic organizers.
We mix it with clay, water, and
so they need this little machine here.
Mm-hmm. You have to do it the exact same.
English language learners need three things. So they need to be able to access the content.
We've been learning all about the process of how cotton plant becomes jeans.
And they need language to be able to participate.
Then, next.
Following this,
okay, ready?
And they need to know how English works.
They bought it, that's a tricky one. We don't say they buy it, right? We say they bought it.
So with all of those supports in place, we can see how our English language learners really have the opportunity not just to survive or make it through in the classroom, but really to excel.
The process concludes when the consumers purchase the jeans and they wear them.
Beautiful job. Round of applause for my friend Ariana. Great job on that.